wish OBS would stop fucking up my little... Ever since the last update, it keeps reorganizing, like, my where my audio mixer and my sources are set. You know? But, B? B? B.
Sorry, my mom came over.
Oh, okay.
What'd you say?
I was about to say, did you die?
Yes.
I was talking about how OBS keeps messing with my, layout. Like, it moves where my audio mixer and my sources are.
What is this place?
Could it be? The Eight Thrones.
Why?
Stop being coy, Ed. Do you know this place or not?
I'm Mimia, the smartest man alive. I know many things.
Well, whatever this place is, it looks important.
To who? There is little of value here.
There's little of value here, but it's the endgame arena. This is where you come to beat the real final boss. The Valkyrie Queen.
Yeah.
She sucks. I can attest, even after playing the original Dark Souls, she's still the hardest boss I've ever fought in any game ever. I've seen people play this game and absolutely destroy her, and I have no idea how they do that.
Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic, after all.
Shut up, Sindri. I know what I'm doing.
Hear you?
Shut up. I know what I'm doing. The dwarven ones... Those are... They're obviously better. But... Oh, I can make some of this stuff. Oh, I unlocked all this because I unlocked Muspelheim. Duh. Forgot I did that. Who the fuck? There we go. Okay. Hopefully nobody messages me anymore.
Why?
'Cause it's annoying. Oh god, yeah, that's right. Oh, I can buy soft Svartalfheim steel. A hard word to say.
I'm sure that'll come in handy.
Not that one. This one. I've got all that crap.
Okay. Nothing to your liking, I see?
Nope. I'll be back later, because you've got better armor for me to buy later. And I won't get the best armor until I unlock Niflheim. Because that's all the armor with all the passive regen stuff. That's the good shit. Because a lot of that stuff has, like, 3 enhancement slots in each piece, and that's the shit I need.
Yeah.
I'm still a ways from getting
all. Which way to the chisel?
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Oh yeah, I can get all the dewdrops of Yggdrasil, too. Strength. Permanent increase to strength.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won, but the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
See, that's another one of the things that I love about this game, is Mimir's stories.
Yeah.
Literally one of the best parts. Love it. Because it's also a lot of legitimate Norse lore.
Yeah.
Whereas the original God of War games dabbled in some of the original lore, this game fully immerses. Guys are level 6. Oh no, I'm having flashbacks. See, what's worse is they're Hellwalkers, and I don't have the blades yet.
Oh.
Yes, yes, that's exactly what I wanted. The axe works on you.
Woo-hoo.
I'm gonna be here for another hour. Boy, this is it. Boom.
seen one of those before. They look like they walk straight out of hell.
That one only took me 3 attempts. The other one took me 12. 15, something like that. Oh, is this... Is this one of the dragons? Am I about to go see one of the dragons?
Ooh, ooh.
Niflheim Cypher Peace. Niflheim Cypher Peace, please.
It's a fragment of a language cipher. We should look for more like this.
Because after I get the Niflheim Cypher, I can activate all the Realm Tower breachers. Oh, yeah,
ah,
the dragon.
Fafnir. I always wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom Fafnir?
The very one.
But Cinder said he was a dwarf.
Was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads?
He's not happy. What happens when I don't play for a while, even though it's only been, little under 24 hours since I played last. This is what happens when I don't play consistently. I fuck up all the time. I'm a bit underpowered for this. I've been saying that this whole game. I'm a bit underpowered for this. Still manages to do it anyway. It just goes right through him. Why? Well, that's some grade A bullshit. that does mean I need to switch back to this, though. So stupid. Would this be better with some visuals instead of just me ranting to myself?
Well, I've played the game before. But sure, I'm also playing Phone on Time.
That other fucker to spawn in so I can kill him. But he refuses to spawn, apparently. It's always when I don't need him around. See, this will be a hell of a lot. This game gets a lot, hell of a lot easier when you have the blades. Because you have two completely different set of runic attacks. Why can't I do it? It's because he keeps spawning in those little guys, and it's really... You'd think they wouldn't be much of a distraction, but they are. Welcome back to it.
How did your friend become a dragon, Mimir?
Oh, he's no friend of mine. Source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Even a greedy little dwarf come dragon.
Stay!
You've never answered the boy's question, Head. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
I don't know for certain, though I'd wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.
Here, boy.
See, I can't finish this if I can't beat that traveler.
Huh!
can't beat that traveler unless I get fucking good, apparently. Hey, thanks for destroying that for me. Got it. Alright, I'm good. I'm still good at this game.
Are you?
Yes. What do you think I'm not? Oh, I forgot about the fucking revenant. I'm an idiot. Why did I forget about the revenant? I don't know. I was not paying attention to my health at all, so that's probably my fault. Damn it. Are you kidding? I'm not this bad. I did it. First dragon freed.
There you go, you wee little bugger.
A brilliant scale of the chain. I don't remember if that one's any good or not. Defense and cooldown. Oh, fuck yeah. Moderate perk activation chance grant to blessing of cooldown on any successful kill. Oh, fuck yeah. I need more slots. I badly need more slots. Hopefully with all the crap I'm going around getting. It will allow me to get all the armors that I need. Because I think the Dwarven Runic set is the next set that I'll be using. And I think it has 2 slots per armor in that.
Oh.
What?
Nah, I just didn't know that.
I think, if I remember correctly. See, I used to know all this stuff off the top of my head, so I would usually skip... I would usually skip a lot of the in-between armors. And just skip straight to the metal plate or the Dwarven Runics armor.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine. For instance, Odin hates the giants and they him. But Thor's own mother is the giantess Björgun, one of Odin's great loves.
So Thor's half god and half giant? Weird.
Once Fjörgun was gone, lonely ages passed for Odin. And as war with the Vanir raged, I could see what he really wanted beneath his bluster. And after no small amount of convincing, Freya agreed. For a while there, he really turned on the charm. He seemed happy. He seemed interested in making her happy. He granted her so many wishes, I could scarcely recall them all. The peace held, and I truly believed all had worked out better than I could have planned. But Odin's true face showed itself again in the end. Oh, he won Freya's trust, and she taught him some of her Vanir magic, another choice she would live to bitterly regret. Sadly, despite his wise counselor's best efforts to persuade him that peace was the only true path to stave off Ragnarok, Odin never let go of his obsession with Jotunheim. The taste of Vanir magic led him to new forms of experimentation and new levels of depravity.
Well, that's what I get for being cocky. Okay, so that guy needs to be my focus. Once I changed my strategy for that, it was piss easy. Just because they're higher level doesn't mean they're any more of a challenge. Stuck here for a wait, here we go. It wasn't hard, it was just me being an idiot. close the thing, and then go all the way back around, and then open it.
Oof.
Too many extra steps. There you are, you little shit. This is the runic attack that I'm looking for. Isn't it? Yes. This is the good shit. Instantly upgrade that. That is now my new heavy runic attack, and it will never change. Having Glaivestorm really would have helped with that last fight. Having Glaivestorm helps with every fight. I don't know why what I'm talking about. It's a really good one.
Obviously, the marriage to Odin didn't last. But how did Frey end up a hermit in the woods?
Oh, that was a singular piece of cruelty, even for Odin. As if the marriage wasn't punishment enough. Freya was better to him than he deserved. She stuck it out through all manner of indignity, all in the name of maintaining peace and safety for her people. But Odin's madness, his tyranny, his corruption of her magics, it became more than she could stomach, and at long last she broke it off. Odin's wrath was fierce, and his curses upon her were more than she dared to fear.
But her magic was so much stronger than hers.
After so much time together, he knew her vulnerabilities, and exploited them to craft curses she could never break.
Oh, like not being able to leave Midgard.
Worse still, he robbed her of her warrior spirit. Freya cannot fight, even to defend herself. No living thing may she harm by blade nor spell. In a world this belligerent, what choice does she have but isolation?
Poor Freya. I guess if I was her, I'd spit in your face too.
Aye, lad. So would I.
Alright. Again, I love that. Every time you get in the boat, you're treated with a story.
Yeah.
It makes the boat sections a hell of a lot less hellacious. See, I have a set of runic attacks that I use for basic enemies, and a set of runic attacks that I use against bosses.
Nice.
The frost beam, excellent at blitzing through bosses, especially if your runic is really, really high.
Come and face me, God of Thunder!
Yeah.
But I'm more of a... Because there's different types of builds you can do. Ooh, what is this? Ooh, this is the parry window talisman. This is one I did not use. Because I was a fool. It passively increases the parry windows of all attacks.
Why wouldn't you use that?
I don't know. Because there are better ones. But at the same time, it's really fucking good.
Challenges mean nothing to the gods, spirit. They do not listen.
Do not mock my pursuit of vengeance. Though my family devoted their lives to worshipping Thor, I've devoted mine to his downfall. And I will start with that statue looming over my father's grave.
Unlikely. You are dead.
Is there something we can do?
For a reward, of course.
If you bring down the statue, you have my blessing to loot my father's grave. He rests on an island.
Ooh, why do you hate Thor so much?
After my father passed, my mother built the statue to watch over his grave. Imagine our surprise when the God of Thunder himself came to offer condolences. At first we were thrilled, but he quickly took advantage of our hospitality. My mother begged him to leave, and Thor, in his drunken rage, killed her. I was left with nothing but grief. Eventually, I lost that as well, and found only rage in its place.
I'm so sorry.
Come, boy. We have a statue to destroy.
Fuck yeah, we do. Destroying Thor's statue is always fun. I need to remember how to activate these water wheels. Still an idiot. Again, the answer was right in front of me. Successful axe kills grant rage burst. Successful axe kills grant a health burst. normally I'd use the versatile warrior's handle for a lot longer. But in this case, I don't think I need to. Boat time again, boy.
That spirit.
The one whose mom was killed by Thor? What about him?
Will his story be a reminder? The lives of men mean nothing to the gods.
I know, Father.
You know. But do you listen?
Yes.
Good.
No. This is Vader Guard, not Conan's Guard. Coming here later, which means I'm going to be able to fight the ancient that's here.
Strong.
All right. Oh no, there are health stones lying around.
Come on!
closer than I would have liked. Hey, Brock.
Look here.
Yes, sir. Vaithargar. Southern outposts of the Dwarven King. Dwarven King? Have you ever heard of a Dwarven King?
No.
Oh, there.
I'd heard rumors of a powerful dwarf ruling over some poor sods not far from here. Not that you asked me.
What do you want, dwarf?
I got another lead on my old pal on Vari. Meet me at the Lawn Soother Mines. There's some fancy-dancy loot in it for you.
Another lead? But we already found him. Well, found his hand anyways.
I'll explain at the mines. These ones is just south of the river pass. Now you two want something, or you just gonna stand there all gag-scrapped and slack-jawed? On Vari's hand at the Velander mines. Feller was always tampering with souls and dark rituals and matters of the night, see? Just the sound of his hammer flattening metal were enough to stoke my fires all blissful. Shit, you better clear out before I get all frisky. Keep them protected, bits off you.
Yeah, I've got enough for the whole set.
Bitch, with the pride.
happened to these people?
Follow the clues.
Okay. Well, scorch marks. They're all grouped together. So maybe they were hiding from some kind of fire breather. But they died anyway.
Here we go!
Here.
Curse the Dwarf King. Bane of mankind. Sounds like he wasn't a very good king. I wonder why they hated him so much.
They are dead now. Does it matter?
No. I'm just curious.
Curiosity is dangerous, boy. Stay focused. Can you read it?
Sir. Veda Dauber. It means... hunting death. Great. Begin to build statues this big.
Dwarves are resourceful creatures. Annoying, but resourceful.
I guess they must have been pretty important dwarves.
Alright, we're gonna knock this sumbitch down.
I have a question. If Ymir was the first giant, where did he come from?
In the beginning, there was Ganungagap. Great void. There were no realms yet. Only primordial forces. There was fire, and there was ice. And there in the void, they met and produced...
water?
More than water. The mystic lifeblood of something entirely new. From this water, Ymir took form and became a being of pure creation and chaos, mother and father to all that came after.
Even the Aesir?
Aye. Every god, man, and beast came first from Ymir's flesh. Though it was the Aesir who thought themselves so superior that they should hold dominion over the rest of creation. It was Odin.
Uh-oh.
Who took arms against his creator and spilled Ymir's lifeblood with his spear. A necessary evil, he would say, to bring order to the realms. From Ymir's torn flesh, Odin would fashion the realm of Midgard for his own. Called himself All-Father, as if he was the creator, and not the creator's destroyer. A small, covetous tyrant!
Ymir?
Huh? Oh. Sorry, my boy. You know, I think it best we just end it there, actually.
Hey, bro.
Father's grave. Find anything good?
Yeah.
Father, we're going to bring down that statue, right?
kill this fucking crow first. Bitch.
There he goes. I was just planning on doing this himself.
Fall this easily, boy.
I know. I was just joking.
Nor are they a joking matter.
Sorry. Father, why did the gods cause so much trouble for us?
Because that is their nature.
But with all that power, you would think at least some of them would try to make life better for people.
And yet, the gods continue to spread misery. This is life, boy.
Sounds like a dragon.
Oh,
I gotta go. There's D&D tonight.
Oh shit. You got D&D, huh?
Yeah.
Well, have fun with that.
Yeah. I'll probably be back.
I'm probably not gonna stay up too much longer anyways.
Heavy draw gun behind.
Oh, dude, I have to work tomorrow.
Yeah, I have to work.
Oh, boo. Well, I'll let you know whenever I'm done, and if you're still up, maybe we can hang out for a little bit more. Alright, have fun.
Alright.
does not concern us.
I know, but it just seems right.
Guard your emotions, boy. Your enemies will not hesitate to kill.
Thank you.
Atreus, follow me. Say, boy.
Sure. It means to believe or to have faith. So they still had faith in their king? Even after he got so many of them killed?
It is a command. To have faith despite his failures. Another one here.
It's Scotty. Mother liked her. The great huntress.
That's right. Queen of the hunt, they called her.
That's her father. And all the animals she hunted.
He taught her well.
And the last panel. Her father again. Both of them. In the snow.
And they're still there. It's quite a story.
Help! place?
A ruin.
Well, yeah. But if a dwarf built it, they must have been impressive back when he ruled.
Itchy leg. Oh, here's the last one.
Look here.
Yes, sir. I think we have a complete settlement. Dwarf can made his subjects hunt dragons and other monsters for him? Some king, huh? You may want to see this. Looks like that lever over there will free him. No, but it feels wrong to keep someone caged like this.
Your emotions again, boy.
I can't hear their thoughts. I can.
Ignore them. Ready yourself.
Okay.
The beast thinking now?
Well, nothing. But he was grateful to die back, instead of rotting in the cage.
Your skill is improving. You fought well, Atreus.
Thank you, Father. fresh air feels good. Don't eat us.
Boy, prepare yourself.
So, what happened to all the people who lived here?
Follow the clues, boy.
Right, right. Follow the clues. Okay, so there was an evil dwarf king, and he made all these people hunt monsters. The people put them in cages, and then I don't know.
We are missing a clue.
Back inside the castle?
No. There is nothing more for us inside. But stay alert for chain dragons, boy. Perhaps you'll uncover more about this dwarf king.
See, you boys ran afoul of some travelers. Or them travelers ran afoul of you, more like.
Who are they? What do they want?
Dunno. Oh, you ask a lot of questions. What's got you all bum-fuzzled over there? Get going.
Oh, almost forgot. Brock, this is our new friend Mimir.
We've met.
Oh, why didn't you say so?
He knows why. I know why. You know why.
Quiet. No more of this.
Know what? Sorry I brought it up. Hey, Brock. You ever hear of a dwarf king?
I suppose you're talking about Motsignir? Some bitch ruled over the humans once lived in this area. Built itself a castle just north of here.
A dwarven castle? What's it like?
You got yourself a pair of eyes and legs, ain't you? Might want to stock up before you head that way, though. Old Motsignir's known for collecting all manner of killerin' creatures. Not sure who's looking after him now.
Can't you and Sindri just patch things up? Whatever happened couldn't be all that bad. Your family.
Now don't be lecturing me about family. I ain't the one what forgot what our name stood for. What we made, the weapons we made were legendary across 9 realms for more years than I can count. You just don't throw that away on account of one bad.
One bad what?
One bad nothing. Ain't you got somewhere to be?
Hey, where's your beast of burden?
What do you mean? I ate her. Fat bits of her out just a while ago.
What is wrong with you?
What? Her milk ran dry.
She was your friend.
And she'll be happy I'm so well fed. Shitbricks, boy, you got a real sentimental streak, know that? Don't get yourself confused out there. I'm getting back to you. All right, what'd you break? were we talking about?
What can you tell me about that giant lady with the bow?
She was called Skadi, Queen of the Hunt. Her father was Thjotsi, who could take the shape of any wild creature, and taught Skadi how to hunt them all. From the ribs of pack beasts, she fashioned second feet, allowing her to glide upon the snow so no animal could evade her. She became a huntress beyond compare, even to any god. Odin himself wanted her for his bride, believing she would bear him strong sons. But she spurned his affections, and for that insult, Odin vowed revenge. It was put forth that the Aesir were plagued by an eagle who would steal the precious golden apples of Idun. Not even the finest archer among the gods could bring it down. Odin knew that Skadi could not resist the temptation to prove herself superior. And so she joined the hunt. Skadi tracked the eagle as it flew where she alone could glide, and loosed an arrow from her unerring bow. When she collected her quarry, she found no foe at all, but her own father, poor Thjotsi, slain by his own daughter. She was overcome with grief and shame, for there is nothing nature so reviles as a child who kills their parent. Skadi succumbed to her fate as winter's blanket fell, holding her father as the mountain held her in an embrace to last eternity.
Well, that was sad.
Aye. There aren't many happy endings for the giants, I'm afraid.
Have you destroyed the statue?
The statue stands no longer, spirit.
Then my bond to this realm is severed, and I am off to find the real God of Thunder. He will know retribution. My deepest gratitude.
Off he goes. Brave guy. Want to look for Thor on his own.
He is a fool.
What did the spirit leave us?
An offering to one of the gods.
Can we use it?
No, but perhaps the dwarves can.
This is where the tower to Jotunheim should be. Feels strange somehow.
No doubt some arcane magics were involved. I would be not at all surprised to learn you were sensitive to that.
can't believe he ate it.
Well, looky who decided to show. Talk to this here ring.
What? I can't hear thoughts from rings, Brock. It's talking to me! It's Anvari!
Ha! Knew it.
He says he went to the Velander mines to observe his mistake. But then the Soul Eater attacked, so as he was being ripped apart, he cast a spell that removed his soul and put in this ring. And then he...
What about all his stuff?
Huh?
Anvari had a workshop here with all sorts of posh doodads and ornatory tools. And one beaut of a hammer. You make mention of it still in there?
You're upsetting him.
Your point? You fellas take Anvari with you and go have a look-see. If you find his hammer, I'll whip up something real nice for you. Hey now, don't go forgetting your entry stone.
Anvari isn't happy about us taking his stuff.
I do not care.
I'm not gonna tell him that. He sounds sad.
The ring's grief is of little importance, boy.
Not like that. He's warning us not to go down there.
Stop listening to the ring, boy. Cannot be trusted. It's that ring, boy.
I don't know how. Ugh.
Here, boy. And a traveler. Guard up.
Oh, dead soul there. What is soul there even doing here? What do you mean it's your fault?
Boy, ignore him.
It's sort of tough for me to ignore.
I see no traps.
You sounded so sure about it.
That's way too good to pass up.
Shop is up there. But I know, I know. Don't trust the talking ring.
Ooh, this one has an enchantment socket.
listen. Invari's crew did something bad here. He's glad you destroyed his lab, and he's sorry he kept trying to trick us. His hammer is just through this gate.
Roy, over here.
Yes, sir.
This is a fine hammer.
Invari says thank you.
Find that hammer, or you too.
Here, the alchemist's hammer. His spirit is a nuisance.
Yeah, Anvari always was an asshole. Hell of an alchemist, though. Hand him over here and I'll melt him down.
What? You're going to melt down your friend?
A trapped soul's what I need to give your reward some extra oomph. You don't want it?
Father, we can't do that. Here, you hold on to him. He's really useful, I promise.
Fine. So long as he proves his worth.
Boom, and Vari's soul.
Kid's a bit of a softy, huh? Well, he'll grow out of it. Tyr would have been pleased as peaches knowing these offerings were being turned to armor.
Did you know him? What was he like?
Never you mind, boy. Tyr's dead. Best not to dig up the past.
The dwarf speaks wisely, for once.
Let's sort you out.
Lost Unity Gauntlets. I mean, I have extra. I might as well.
Don't be too careful now.
I need pure essence of realms to upgrade this one. Oh shit. But
well,
it is.
See you next time you need something.
It is one of the more dubiously useful ones. Until I get the Gauntlet of Ages. I think that's what I'm getting in the next one. Is I get the Gauntlet of Ages. Which, with the different, that's what I need on the Dragon Tears. Thank you.
Yankees old. A world serpent?
Too small.
Yeah, but maybe Thor's just really big?
Unlikely.
When damage is taken. Oh, fuck.
What's hiding behind there?
No earthly key nor physical force can get past the magic of that lock. Don't even look at it.
If I remember correctly, yeah, I can't go in those doors yet. Am I remembering correctly? Might not be. Oh, I need really
Atreus, follow me.
Be right there. I see something down there. That's an interesting gate. I wonder who built it. Like there was an entire city under the water.
My lad, a forgotten city.
What was it called?
Well, I forgot.
And I saw another one over here.
We can beach over here.
I think this is the way to Conan's Guard. If I remember correctly, I may not be remembering correctly. I also realized I have not been talking hardly at all. I am just... I'm too immersed into the game. It's either this way or that other way is the way to Conan's Guard. It might be that way.
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir. language cipher. Good.
Yes, very good. Wait, this is the way to... So I was right. The other way is to Conan's Guard. I think I may do this one and then be done. I'm fucking tired, guys.
Can we dock here?
Once you retrieve the whetstone, please take utmost care while handling it. It is a priceless relic.
Hey, Sindri, have you met Mimir?
If you mean the severed head that keeps blinking at me, please, keep it away. There is no possible way that's hygienic.
Oh, that's nice. Lovely to see you too, Sindri.
Nob.
Why? Is that a piece of my braided mistletoe arrow adorning your quiver strap? Oh, a little memento of your good pal, Sindri? I'm so terribly touched. Get to it.
I can't upgrade any of this. I would love to. I'd love to upgrade this. See, this only grants defense, but it'll grant more.
Sometimes the best purchase is the one you don't.
I still can't believe a son would kill his own father. That's crazy, right? I know, we only got one side of the story. But come on, his own father? I mean, I get angry at you sometimes, but...
Do you?
I mean, sometimes, yeah. A little. But I'd never stab you in the back.
No. Right.
This clan really didn't want anyone coming in. How are we supposed to get through?
There must be a way to lift the gate.
Maybe with the big water wheel.
My thought as well.
Yeah. sometimes when you don't think I can do something, but I can.
It is not always easy to know what.
It's okay. I get it. I'm little. Where's that whetstone, I wonder?
Yeah, I gotta click back into the frickin' game.
Look here.
Kratos.
This is the sun.
That ghost stone? How do you know?
The sigil. It matches the dagger we found in his father's back. He stood his ground, but it was not enough.
He betrayed him.
Betrayal begets betrayal. My guess, the young one murdering his dad didn't sit well with the others.
He thought himself ready to lead. It cost him his life.
I guess.
Look there, lad. By his feet.
The whetstone!
Yes. They used it to smash his face in.
They did? Ew. Stone behind. If Sindri wants it, he might. Must be really useful.
Well, lad, reavers have very specific priorities. If it's not shiny and you can't eat or drink it, may as well use it as a blunt object.
Boy, over here.
Sir.
There's a scroll here. It belonged to the sun. Wow, this goes on and on. Father, forgive me. Filled with remorse. Forget my actions.
Had he thought before taking action, there would be no need for regret, yes?
Yeah. Maybe we should bring this to his father. Back at the storeroom.
Check and then I'll be done.
Boy, over here.
Yes, sir.
This says, false leaders. I've seen it written all over this place. Dock here.
I wish you'd give me more than one at a time. I know at one point they're gonna start giving me them two at a time.
How did it go at the stronghold?
We found your whetstone.
Oh, wonderful! This staining is unusual.
The Reavers used it to smash another Reaver's face in.
Oh, wonderful. Here, for your trouble. Ooh! Yes!
This is the grip I'm gonna be using for a long time.
I can't wait to test out the new whetstone. It may not look like much, but it's practically humming with magic. I've needed a new one after my brother borrowed the last one. I saw him spit on it.
To lube it out,
he said. I didn't ask for it back.
See, I need more Dust of Realms. I can upgrade these. Better to upgrade two.
I say so. Myself. Happy to provide.
Thank you. any hack silver is better than no hack silver, is what I say. The realms. Oh, duh. I'm so blind. Another Nornir chest done. I think there's only a couple left, right? never get more health is... hard work. Is to upgrade my vitality. And to upgrade my vitality, I need better armors. And the only better armors that have super high vitality is the Niflheim armors, which are the end-all, be-all.
It is over.
That health burst is gonna save my ass in a lot of situations. Oh, Ratatusker. Pristine scales of the realm. I'm gonna do this, and then I'm done. I'm gonna be done for the day. perfect eye of the realm. Increase all frost damage. Fuck yeah, that's good. But this has 25% resistance to all status effects. See, I'm only losing one vitality, but I'm gaining all these other things with Anvari's soul.